can turn the world on with a smile. You can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile. What a true girl, and you should know it. Each pleasure and every little movement you show it.
Love is all around.
No need to fake it.
You can never tell.
Why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the show. Today is Thursday, April 19th. And Mark has 810 days left to serve in his sentence. And of course, tomorrow is the big April 20th, but I'll talk more about that in a moment. First, I'm going to show you some photos I got of Mark and his band, Yazoo. These are five photos here of Mark and his bandmates. And I don't remember all of their names, but he's written about them in his blogs, so you can check that out at cannabisculture.com and freemark.ca. But we've got these five pictures, and they're all very serious, and Mark is always very smiley. So prisoners typically try and look tough in their pictures, but Mark can't help but be the smiley guy that he is. So those are great fun, and Mark has commissioned our friend and artist Gary Wintle, who made the Freemark logo, to draw a picture of all the band members holding their instruments so Mark can have a prison concert poster for his band Yazoo. So again, there's an example of Mark just making the most of where he's at and trying to have a good time as much as he can. So it's been a pretty busy week. Last week's show, I told you that it was going to be very interesting this week, and there was some secret stuff going on. So if you've been to cannabisculture.com or you watch our Facebook or Twitter or websites at all, you'll see that the news broke about me appearing with Mark's prosecutor, John McKay. Now, first, before this even happened, I'd been invited by the National Post newspaper, which is one of only two cross-country papers, and it's the one that our conservative government reads and most conservatives read. But the National Post asked me for an op-ed on marijuana legalization, and today they ran it in the Issues and Ideas page. And you can see the op-ed by going to my Facebook page at facebook.com/Jodie Emery, and I'll be sure to have a picture up on the screen here. But I'll post a blog on cannabisculture.com and you can read it and check it out there. I forget that not everybody's on Facebook, so I'll be sure to share that. But it's a great argument about the victims of the drug war and how it's more than just an economic cost, this prohibition, but there's also a human cost. So I was very pleased with that, and there's been a huge response to it. But that was because yesterday was an even bigger news day and the momentum is just carrying over. So yesterday morning, I was invited to be at this press conference with John McKay, who is Mark's prosecutor, and Jeff Plant, who's a former attorney general in BC, who has called for legalization. The group Stop the Violence BC, which I've told you all about, is phenomenal. They've gotten a lot of high-profile experts and past politicians to come on board, and I was invited to join this event with them. So John McKay and I met last year, actually, when I testified at the Washington State Legislature alongside him in favor of legalization. So we met again this time, and it was very pleasant. I actually have to say we were both very cordial to each other, and he again reiterated that I was very gracious. He did say that he doesn't think Mark did the right thing, but I explained why Mark's actions were necessary. And I encourage you to check out the video of the entire event. It's been uploaded to my YouTube account, youtube.com/Jodie Emery, because it's almost an hour long, so we put it on that account. But we'll get the clips of my responses to questions and some other videos available for you too. It was a press conference, just to say, legalized marijuana, and it got every representative of every Canadian media outlet was there. We had huge amounts of coverage. So I have a few samples here for you. The Metro News, which is one of our free papers here in Vancouver, did an article with me looking pretty smiley to be up there and got some excellent quotes where I explained that civil disobedience is necessary to undo unjust laws. And we got the 24 Hours, another free paper in town. They have their article, Prince of Pot Prosecutor, now pro-pot. We got the Province newspaper, our provincial newspaper, ran a big story near the front, the same thing. A picture of me and John McKay, again, allies on the same side of the battle now. So it was good to welcome him over to the good guys' side. And the Vancouver Sun Ian Mulgrew wrote a big column there about the same thing. Emery's prosecutor wants pot legalized. So these are just samples of the ones I grabbed today, but there are countless articles online and on radio, on TV. I've been doing tons of stuff yesterday, today, and tomorrow. It's going to be nonstop, even through to Saturday. So that's big news because it shows that even though we have people who were our enemies at one time, who are carrying out the policing and persecution of the drug war, once they admit they're wrong, even though you can kind of be a little suspect of them and their motivations, at least it's better that they're now on our side instead of continuing to be on the other side. So that's why I'm always happy to welcome and invite any new allies to join us, no matter what their background is, because people like John McKay bring a lot of weight and a lot of credibility with him for those who are in the law enforcement and political arena. So kudos to him and everyone else who was there. It was an honor to be on stage with such big names and to get such a great response from the media, because all of the news says this is the right answer, and where is the federal government on this? Why aren't they responding to it? Please check out the front page of cannabisculture.com. We have tons of news stories. Harper even said himself, our prime minister said, the drug war is a failure. But he has something else up his sleeve. He doesn't believe in legalization. But still, the story is in the news and it's not going away. And of course, we've got 420 tomorrow, the worldwide day of celebration and protest against prohibition. So come down to Vancouver if you're here, or if you're in a city where there's an event taking place, be sure to go and show your support. We have an article on the front page of cannabisculture.com that lists all of the cities that are holding rallies. And 420vancouver.com, our new website, has information about our event here. Libby Davies, a member of parliament, will be speaking again this year. That's a fantastic accomplishment to get her on board again. She's been a great friend to our cause, though, so I'm just happy to see her coming by. And we're going to be sure to educate as many people as we can about the fact that they're all at risk of persecution for their peaceful, honest choice to use marijuana, and that they have to take action to try and change these laws so that they don't face that risk and danger of being arrested or imprisoned. So that's the point of our day, and again, be sure to check out cannabisculture.com. We're actually going to be live streaming the 420 event from the hotel right next door to the rally at the art gallery. So you can tune in to cannabisculture.com, and we'll have Pot TV on the scene in Cannabis Culture to bring you all the great excitement of the day. And it's a big deal for everyone here, and we're really looking forward to it. We have a new tank top I want to show you, a free mark tank top we got for girls. This is a limited edition at Cannabis Culture headquarters store. It's, I think it's a wife beater tee. I think that's what it's called. But let's say it's a weed smoker tee. But the back says Mark's slogan, plant the seeds of freedom, overgrow the government. And that's an exciting new addition to our store. And we've got tons of stuff coming in store all the time. Great expansions and improvements. So be sure to check it out in town or at cannabisculture.com/store. And I am going to do the giveaway. I didn't announce it last week, but every week I will do the giveaway. And again, it'll be another free mark t-shirt. So I didn't really promote my last show that much, but that gave better odds to the people who did enter, who were wondering if there even was a contest still, because I didn't mention it. So 25 people entered the contest, and you do that by sending an email to jodie@cannabisculture.com, and I'll put you in the bubble bag for drawing your name for a prize. So this week, the winner is going to be Jim B. So, hi Jody, I hope all is good with you. Any word yet about Mark getting transferred to a Canadian prison? Well, Mark had tried to get transferred last year and was refused by the US government, and he can apply again next year, and hopefully that'll get approved. But at this point, he's just doing his time down in Yazoo City, Mississippi, and we have a bit over 2 years to go. So no news on that, but it would be wonderful if every prisoner in the US for pot was pardoned and released. And let me just remind you all, Ron Paul as president would pardon all nonviolent drug offenders. So if you care about getting people out of prison, you know who you should vote for. But I won't give you too much more on that. You all know how much I love that man and admire him for being a freedom fighter, just as I admire anybody who's defending the liberty of all individuals. Be sure to throw your support behind any politician who is defending our cause for justice and peace and liberty. So I'll give another t-shirt. This one is going to Jim, and I'll be doing a draw next week as well. So send your entry to jodie@cannabisculture.com. And please be sure to check out the videos and news stories about me and John McKay appearing together. I think it was a really great, great day, and Mark is super, super proud of me. And this is going to create a lot of momentum, and I feel like I've earned a few stripes amongst the media and some drug policy reformers here. So I'm not just a pot activist, and I'm not just Mark's wife. I think I have something important to say. And again, it was a great honor to sit beside a former Attorney General of BC and former District Attorney from Washington State, and have them not afraid at all to shake my hand and smile and be there with me. So we're gaining ground, everybody. There's still a lot of positivity out there. Harper and the conservatives and Obama and his buddies, left, right, it doesn't matter. The people who are warmongers, they're coming up against a lot of opposition. Our cause is only getting stronger. And tomorrow's a great day to celebrate our culture and to protest prohibition, because while you're out there getting high at your rally, if you're able to do so, you've got to remember that somewhere else, somebody's being arrested at that very moment and facing the destruction of their lives. So it's not just a party, it's also a protest. And I hope to see you in Vancouver sometime soon. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. And free Mark Emery.
Well, the great thing about prison is that they made me take a drug education course. I ended up teaching it.
American dollars at work.
Yeah, they didn't know. They were teaching things like marijuana is a dangerous drug. And I had to tell them, man, marijuana is the friendliest drug you'll ever meet in your life. It's the only drug I know where you take a hit, your first impulse is to give it to somebody.